Kingdom of Eswatini, Your Excellency Mr. Joy Lorenzo, President of the Republic of Angola and Chairperson of Southern African Development Community, Your Excellency Dr. Emmerson Mabuza Mnangagwa, President of the Republic of Zimbabwe and incoming Chair of SADC, Your Excellencies Heads of State and Government present here, all protocols of staff, Mr. Elias Magosi, Executive Secretary of the Southern African Development Community, Honorable Ministers here present, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. It is an honor to address the 44th SADC Summit of Heads of State and Government on the theme of promoting innovation to unlock opportunities for sustained economic growth and development towards an industrialized SADC. I want to start by conveying my gratitude to the government of Zimbabwe for the generous hospitality as the host of this August event here in Harare. I also wish to thank the heads of state and SADC for this opportunity to deliver my inaugural address in my capacity as the Executive Secretary of the United Nations Economic Commission for Africa. Excellencies, distinguished delegates, we are meeting at a time when our continent is facing major challenges, especially financing, security, sovereign debt crisis, and climate change. Sovereign debt in Africa currently stands at over $1 trillion, causing severe fiscal stress, with more than one in three countries in or at high risk of debt distress. This is also happening when long-term concessional finance, official development assistance, and foreign direct investments are declining. In addition, climate change is eroding 5% of GDP on average on an annual basis. Actually, last year for Mozambique, it cost them 15% of their GDP. These impacts are quite evident in the SADC region. That's why we're working on an African position on the reform of the global financial architecture so that Africa's needs are taken into account at the next month's Summit of the Future and the fourth Financing for Development Conference that will take place next year in Spain. Excellencies, distinguished delegates, there are no clear solutions. We have no choice but to look inwards for homegrown solutions, including domestic resource mobilization and innovative financing for climate to sustain our development. And SADC can be a leader on this imperative. The region is home to most of the world's gold, copper, cobalt, lithium, chromium, graphite, platinum, and possesses significant livestock and agriculture endowments. Four key areas offer SADC innovative and scalable solutions. One of them is the development of the regional value chain, and this is possible in the whole of SADC region. Regional agglomeration remains a ticket to sustainable industrialization because fragmented approaches will not generate the jobs we need, nor will it reduce poverty and inequality. Indeed, following our recent visit to Botswana, Namibia, and Ethiopia to study the beef and leather value chains, we have concluded that all SADC offers enormous potential to increase export markets within these sectors. That's why we partnered with the Arab Bank for Economic Development in Africa, ADEA, who have now approved grant financing for a feasibility study in the beef sector for Botswana that will be conducted by ECA, working closely with SADC Secretariat and partners. This will be replicated in other SADC member countries. We also plan to boost our work for the leather sector. In tandem is the energy regional value chain. We must approach energy solutions from a regional perspective to have significant impact. For example, SADC is using only 1% of the solar and wind energy potential. This means that SADC can be a continental energy provider with the development of this value chain alone. Excellencies, distinguished delegates, the second area of opportunity is food security. There is no reason why Africa should import food to the tune of over $120 billion per year when SADC can be Africa's breadbasket. This is also why we are embarking on the establishment of the Zambia-Zimbabwe Common Agro-Industrial Park, again working with BADEA, who have also approved grant financing for a study to move forward with this initiative. I'm glad that the president of BADEA himself is here in the room with us. Thank you very much. This is not just critical for SADC, but for the whole of the African continent. Thirdly is the minerals development. Our critical minerals can deliver fair and inclusive prosperity. Our fundamentals for the agenda are stronger than anywhere else in the world. But our window of opportunity is closed. We are using our study on the DRC Zambia Electric Battery Initiative as a proof of concept that we can and should drive mineral beneficiation, and we are working on a roadmap to translate this into a reality that will allow expansion to other minerals such as diamond. Finally, we must leverage technology. Our work with Botswana on the local small stock farm shows the benefits of using smart agriculture technologies for climate change adaptation. With the right investments, we can scale up innovations like this, and not just in the agriculture sector, but in health, education, finance, transport, and many more others. ECA is now developing a platform that showcases innovations across the continent, which can be accessed by all countries. This was one of the requests by member states at our last conference of finance ministers in March this year in the beautiful Victoria Falls. This year's conference of ministers of finance, planning, economic development, and governors of the central bank is chaired by the finance minister of Zimbabwe. This, notwithstanding, significant investments and critical infrastructure development is needed to unlock these opportunities. Governments alone cannot do this. The private sector can play its part with the right incentives and the de-risking mechanism. For us at ECA, we are working closely with the African Development Bank and regional partners to enhance the de-risking mechanisms that promote successful public-private sector partnerships. Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, as I conclude, let me emphasize that the impetus for rapid industrialization is not simply a question of convenience. It's a matter of absolute necessity. Homegrown solutions can help us address today's complex challenges. We are here because we believe we can do it. I'm convinced that each of the SADC member countries can be a cluster leader of innovation and breakthroughs, and ECA stands ready to partner with you on this journey. I thank you very much for your kind attention.